Hey everyone, Pete Estes here. Welcome to this year's final episode of Catamount Weekly presented by Xfinity. Today is Jersey Day, or a hockey jersey, or any type of jersey, as a sign of support for the Humboldt Broncos and the victims of last week's tragic bus crash. This morning, the Vermont men's hockey team gathered in their respective jerseys to show their continued support for the Humboldt community. The number 37 jersey behind me is that of Vermont defenseman and Saskatchewan native Corey Thomas. It will be signed and sent to the Humboldt Broncos.
Yeah, the idea behind the jersey, again, we talked to our players a little bit, and they obviously wanted to do something to recognize and honor the Humboldt Broncos. So the jersey is Corey Thomas's jersey. He wears number 37. We'll leave it hanging up in the locker room with the sticks out for a few days, and then we'll have the team sign it. Corey's going to write a pretty emotional letter, and we'll mail it out to the Broncos organization.
The NHL playoffs got underway last night, as did the quest for a Stanley Cup for two former Catamount captains, Torrey Mitchell and Kevin Miller. Mitchell and the LA Kings started their playoff run last night against the Vegas Golden Knights. In nearly 50 games for the Kings this year after being traded from Montreal, Mitchell scored 6 goals and had 5 assists. Miller and the Boston Bruins take on the Toronto Maple Leafs starting tonight on the NBC Sports Network. An assistant captain for the Bees, Miller posted a career-high 15 assists this season. Speaking of former Catamounts, one of the greats called it a career earlier this week. Chicago Blackhawks forward and 3-time Stanley Cup champion Patrick Sharp announced his retirement. In 939 NHL games, Sharp scored 287 goals and dished out 333 assists. The 4-time NHL All-Star and Olympic gold medalist played his final game last Saturday against the Winnipeg Jets. Former women's hockey captain and Olympic gold medalist Amanda Pelkey was back on campus this weekend. She hosted a youth clinic and then addressed the crowd at Saturday's men's lacrosse game before signing autographs for fans. She spoke to Catamount TV about what it means to come back to Catamount country.
So to be able to fit this in is close to my heart. So to be able to fit stuff in where I can interact with kids, both girls, boys, their parents, and share it with them is what matters the most to me. This is my first time being back to UVM probably a year. I think I came to a women's game, but from winning the medal, this has been the first time. So obviously every time I step into Gutterson, I get really excited. Getting off the exit, I get excited. And it's pretty cool that they're honoring me and another Olympian at the lacrosse game, you know, aside from hockey, just sports in general. Is really cool that we're going to be celebrating him as well. Quite honestly, every single time we're going to an NHL game, dropping the puck, or we're, you know, on a bigger stage where it does kind of hit you that, you know, this is real. Like we're ultimately like changing the world in the sense that, you know, it's been 20 years since they've won. So to be the group that broke that curse, we've seen, you know, all over the United States how it's been impacting different populations, whether it be people that aren't even in sports at all and they're just influenced by our win, or if it's little girls and little boys looking up to our team. So getting it from both sides, aside from sports, and having it just be a motivational thing for everyone and every age, every gender, everything is really cool.
In other women's hockey news, it was just announced that senior forward Kourtney Menches is being recognized by the NSCA as a 2018 All-American Strength and Conditioning Athlete of the Year for collegiate hockey. She holds the team record in the front squat, bench press, and chin-ups. She's also planning on pursuing a career in strength and conditioning after graduation. A couple of reminders before we say so long for the summer. The Catamount Challenge begins today. You can head over to uvmathletics.com for all the information on how you can help support the Catamounts. The 14th Annual Rally Awards will take place on Tuesday, May 8th, down at the Flynn Center for the Performing Arts in downtown Burlington. That event is free and open to the public. And that'll do it for us today on Catamount Weekly presented by Xfinity. Thanks so much for tuning in all year, and we'll see you next fall.